So what does this bill really mean for all of us, for our families, our friends, small business owners, right? Joining me via Skype is Cathy DeWitt Dunn, president and CEO of DeWitt Dunn Financial Services. Good morning, Cathy. Do we have Cathy? Cathy, good morning.
Hey, good morning. Thank you for having me. Wow, this bill is very exciting news.
Yes, absolutely. Tell us about this bill, okay? It sounds enticing to some people, but can you tell us exactly what it means for the average person, small businesses perhaps?
Absolutely. This bill promises checks to household, emergency loans for small businesses and resources for hospitals, and also enhanced unemployment insurance. So we're waiting to see the final bill, but it really is helping a lot of people and families. It's promising $1,200 to most adults and $500 for children. So it's really exciting that we're going to be able to see some money coming in right now.
Well, can I ask you this? Folks get some of these checks. What should they be doing with the money that they will likely receive?
Well, I think, you know, one of the challenges is that it's really helped all of the people that have been laid off, and we're hoping to stir the economy to really get it moving in the right direction. So we're hoping to get that money circulating in the economy so we don't really head to a recession. But, you know, one of the things that we do have is when we have this money from the government, what do we do with it? That's the biggest thing. So we need to take a look at eliminating our debt, making sure that we tackle that. If you have money coming in, make sure that you're safe and you have an emergency fund. And also, you know, take a look at your retirement accounts right now. Put some money aside, because all of these things really are going to impact us in the future.
Okay, you just mentioned possibly paying some things off, getting rid of some of that debt. But what if, you know, some folks probably just don't have enough to go around? What advice do you have for those people just struggling to figure out, you know, which bill to pay during this time?
You know, I think that's a really great question, because I think a lot of people are going to be struggling. And I think you need to take a look at, you know, any debt that you have. And there's two popular methods. The avalanche method encourages you to tackle the debt that has the highest interest rate first, because we really need to get rid of some of that debt that's hanging out there. And then there's another snowball effect, is starting with the smallest balance first and making sure that you pay that off. But whatever you do, if you're struggling, you need to meet with your financial advisor or someone that can help you get on the path, because these are very uncertain times. But with the government helping us right now, we need to make the best of this situation.
Yeah, and of course, reaching out to those companies of, you know, with those bills, maybe to see if they have something that they're offering. What about spending money on big purchases during this time? What feedback do you have for those folks?
Well, I think you need to go back and take a look at your budget that you hopefully had when you began, you know, January of 2020. And I think big purchase items right now, if you are in a financial situation and you're able to handle that, a lot of companies are offering 0% financing. I'm seeing, you know, cars right now that are being offered, you know, no payments for 6 months. So just make sure whatever you're doing, that it's within your budget and the amount of money that you expect to receive and that you can count on, because the last thing you want to do is to end up in a really big financial mess later down the road. And once again, it's meeting with your financial planner, making sure you have a plan in place and staying within your budget.
Yeah, one of the key things you just mentioned, that money that you can absolutely count on. Very, very important. Another thing that I want to get to, Cathy, Wall Street. It's been a volatile month on Wall Street. Is there anything we should be doing right now with our money?
You know, that's a great question. I think one of the challenges is a lot of people have a tendency to take a look at their, you know, their 401ks, all of their investment accounts, and they're looking at them on, you know, a day-to-day basis or hour-to-hour basis. Maybe we just need to take a look at it over, you know, a week or once a month. As we do know, markets always come back, but you really need to take a look at how you're allocated, call your financial advisor, take a look at your retirement horizon, have a plan in place. You can retire. Let's not allow the financial meltdown in the market right now interfere with our retirement plan. So make sure you're working with a great financial advisor that's on the same page that you are.
Okay, Cathy, thank you so much. Truly appreciate it.